ICN 的观众朋友们，你们好！我们新开了一个栏目，叫做《移民美国》。这个栏目呢，将介绍您该如何移民到美国，用什么办法移民到美国。我们请的这些大律师们给你们一一进行诠释。好，现在请我们来介绍一下哈，我们的这个洛杉矶乃至于整个美国的这个知名的大律师苏律师。
最早我是从北京来的，我是北京人。1985年就来美国了。这是虽然我不太老，但是已经是老律师了。
不，您看上去很帅，很有性格，是吧？好，现在我们接着，让我们来大家这个给我们观众介绍一下 Ron。
I've been practicing law since October of 2015. I graduated from UCLA Law School.
Welcome. We're honored to have you.
My name is Thomas Mayer.
Uh-huh. 最近啊，我听说了。我是不知道这个人哈、，Who is Joe 啊？这个他叫 Libo Joe， 他是一个非常有名的一个脱口秀，对不对？他在纽约长岛犯了案，这是怎么回事？你知道他 Who is Joe？
我知道你在想什么，两个多月没见对吧？激动，你以为我也抓进去了对吧？肯定以为最近娱乐圈扎进去不少人，然后两个月没见我
呀，波波老师们不在了，哎呦，
我是不可能有这种问题的，你放心，吸毒这种事情可以做的，不能做，我这辈子不可能吸毒，我就算贩毒也不会去吸毒，呸，怎么可以贩毒呢？不可以这样。
January 19th, midnight in Long Island.Famous Chinese stand-up comedian Zhou Libo was found driving recklessly. So he was stopped by police and inspected. The police found firearms and crack cocaine. Zhou and his companion were arrested on site. They were charged with illegal possession of controlled substances and a firearm. In the morning of January 21st, he appeared in the First District Court. Zhou was released from jail on $5,000 bail.In early August, news outlets reported that the charges on Joe's companion were withdrawn.
Zhou Libo 呢，我当然不认识了，但是还是知道这个人，因为他呢，我已经看过他的节目。那么，我觉得这个从案件来讲呢，目前应该是他的律师代表他和政府检方在谈判，对吧？那么是认不认罪？如果不认，那么政府就要有一个正式的开庭审判。如果认罪了，那么就是说他认什么样的罪，是轻一点的罪呢，还是这个检方不同意，对吧？检方可以给他轻一点的罪让认罪，也可以坚持，如果证据确凿就在你车里找到这些东西，那么我就要判你按照正常的去判，也有可能。所以这个从这一点来讲，他的目前的情况是
不乐观，
很不妙，不乐观，对，
不乐观。据说他是非法持枪。
对，这个非法持枪的概念，我的理解是，对，我的理解是说，比如他有枪照，对吧？这个枪呢只能放在家里面，不能带在车上，那么他就以非法持枪，
这就是一条罪。
对，
这就算一条罪，
这本身就是一条罪。毒呢，也有分几种，对吧 ？Cocaine, according to the immigration law, possession of cocaine is a aggravated felony, right?
Exactly.
我唯一的话就是今天我们不能打这个官司在媒体面前，我们今天这个官司现在经过法律程序，我们会面对法律程序，我们唯一的就要强调这把枪是个合法枪。
律师也是合法的，太太也是合法的，我也是合法的，没事，
好吧。
所以您有信心可以把这件事情处理好吗？
不存在信心，根本就没有事，本来就没有事的嘛。
那您期待个什么样的结果？
没有期待，明天会更好。好。 中国应该帮中国人，对吧？
那个金额只是5000块，
赎金，
就是啊，嗯，这个来证明这个案子啊，就不会太严重了 ，OK。第二个，那很多律师的评论啊，又说45年啊，多少年啊，这些都是不能这样评论的，因为具体的 evidence 就是具体的证据还没有。那究竟这些东西是朱立波的呢，还是他那个朋友呢？还没有讲清楚，对不对？那个车是属于谁的呢？都还没有讲清楚，就是说一切的证据都没有解决掉。而且只是5000块钱的保押金，那证明这个案子啊，不是太那个严重了 ，OK？
但目前还只是叫做说他是这样，对吧？他没有承认，那么在他没有承认的时候，你就不能说他是犯罪了，对吧？还必须要，如果他不承认，那么政府就要拿出证据来，由陪审团来决定他有没有犯罪。所以现在你不能说他犯罪。
If he has a green card, he immigrant American already. What do you do different from this case?
If somebody has a green card and they are charged with possession of cocaine, very very important that I talk to their criminal attorney and let him know that if this client is convicted.That it will mean that they will lose their green card, and they will be removed from the United States.
如果他定罪的话，
对
吧？
定罪啊，对对对。
如果定罪说他是持有毒品，那么就可以取消他的绿卡，把他递解出境。
一定会递解出境。
一定会。
Deport him out America.
To add on to what you're saying earlier, immigration law and criminal law. This is one of the points where they sort of butt heads.Because from a criminal perspective, the criminal attorney will try to say, well, clearly you were in possession, you should just plead guilty so you get a lesser sentence. But you can't really do that if you're also not a citizen. If you're a green card holder, or if you're just on a visitor visa, if you plead guilty, then you're going to be deported. So it's one of those situations where...
Guilty or not guilty is different. It's different for the green card, right?
Yes, in the sense that if you're a citizen, all you care about is your sentence time, essentially. But then if you're not a citizen, you're a green card holder, you also have to worry about my immigration status. So if you sacrifice your time in prison, if you focus only on your sentence, then you'll be sacrificing your green card, potentially.
There are three things that the U.S. Immigration Service really, really hates. One would be if you get caught trafficking other people, smuggling people into the country.
Oh, really?
Yes. The second thing would be drugs. If you're caught with an amount of drugs over a very small amount, it is assumed under our laws that you're distributing drugs, you're selling them, which makes things much worse. Then the third thing,would be any sort of spousal abuse. If you have a record of beating up girlfriends or your wife, that can get you...
What about a wife to the husband?
Well, if she has a green card, then she's, the law applies equally to her.
Same law to,
yes.
the same people.
Right. So, I mean, in some, not the Chinese culture, certainly, but other cultures, beating your wife is somewhat acceptable, maybe very acceptable. But if you do it here, it'll get you thrown out of the country.
这个移民局最恨这三种，
对
最不能谅解这个三种哈。那也是会，如果他是非法移民，或者是他有绿卡，也会递解出境吗？
对。
那很重啊，
有绿卡当然也是，因为你是犯罪了嘛。这三种罪都是在移民法上是可以被递解出境的罪。有些罪就是你犯罪了，你可以在美国服刑，然后不一定按照法律来讲不能够把你递解出境。那么这三种罪那是
肯定，
只要你犯了，只要你被定罪了， 那么你一定要会被递交出境，你没有什么其他的理由可以留下来。
是证据说话，美国所有的罪都是讲证据的，证据然后交给这个陪审团，陪审团才来 evaluate 说评估这些证据，要读，然后要搞出一个结果，然后交给这个法官才有一个判例啊。如果是谋杀犯的话 ，OK， 那个人就是对这个社区会造成危险了 ，OK， 那造成危险的话，他可能100万、500万、800万。你刚才不是一个中国的女的谋杀了她的前男朋友是前夫吗？要八百万的，对，还是800万是8000万的担保？
您说的这个8000万那个
8000万的担保，
那个李女士，
对啊，
前夫
是啊，那太厉害，那就是他还有，他既然可以杀这个人，那可以杀别的人呐、对不对啊？
那怎么决定说是他杀的？没有证，
没有
审判结果
啊。但是那个法官就觉得是他，法官有一个法官有一个权 ，OK， 决定多少钱的担保费、保释费。保释费越大，证明这个人出来能够对社会、对其他人造成这个伤害。那周立波这个法官呢，就没有看到周立波会对别人 ，OK， 会造成多少的伤害。所以他是5000块钱担保费，非常低。
不是这样，法官呢定的是3500万，政府这个检方呢要求是这个1亿的备用，因为他们觉得他是会有钱可以出来的。
大家记住，1亿是美金哦。
对，1亿美金，但是呢，法官给最后给降到3500万，那也相当高了。那么3500万是现金，如果你要付现金，3500万就可以了。他没有那么多钱。那么他现在据说是有20个亲属朋友，帮助他来担保，那么用自己的财产、房产之类的，所以不是现金，那么就变成了7000万，就用7000万的财产作为抵押把他保住。
我这个有个问题了，这么一个国家，这个犯罪杀人，然后拿钱可以摆平吗？
这不是摆平
啊，
这是说在
什么叫赎出来，或者是
就在
担保出来，
就是所有的人，这是美国宪法规定的啊。就是说任何人在，因为他警察把你抓起来，政府把你抓起来，你并不是你已经有罪了，而是你是个犯罪嫌疑犯，对吧？
对。
那么不能因为说我是犯罪嫌疑犯，我就要一直被关着，直到你定了罪之后，我判我10年，我住10年监狱，那是合理的，对吧？但是只要你指控我，我就在监狱待着的话，那就不合理。所以在这个时候他允许你保释出去。
那这个钱将来判完之后，这钱还拿得回来吗？
对，只要你回去，
回到监狱，
除非你不回去了，对吧？那么，这个，你这个钱就给你没收了，就变成这个政府的财产了。但是只要你按时回去，比如说通知你出庭，你去了就没问题了，什么问题都没有。最后把钱还给你，再给你判10年，你服刑，这个钱还给你了。
理论上，在刑事法律陪审团要定一个人罪还是无罪，他们并不应该知道这个人是不是美国公民，只是保密的。这种事情，一个人的移民身份不给陪审团知道。所以严格来讲，他们不应该知道这个，也不能考虑这个。如果你是公民呢，不可能你做，不管你做了什么，你不会被递交出境的。如果你是绿卡，或是也不是美国公民，某一些罪行可以造成你被递交出境。比如说，那当然杀人，或是很多毒品的案子也是可以造成人家被递交出境。涉及到暴力方面的案子也是可以让你被递交出境。可是这些对美国公民没有什么影响。
如果他已经是公民，当然他肯定就他再也不会跟移民局打交道了。OK， 那就纯粹是在刑事法院里边该怎么处理就怎么处理。
对。
然后还有一些人是有绿卡的人，
嗯哼，
那还有一些人是连绿卡都没有，就是比如说学生签证的人，
嗯，
或者是观光签证的人，
嗯，
H1 工作签证的人，所以这些人是还没有绿卡的身份。那这个根据他们犯的罪，最后定什么样的罪，就会在移民的身份上面就会有很不同的一个结果了。
嗯，
就算你有绿卡，但是你犯了某些罪，就是刚才包律师谈到这个暴力的一些罪啊，
嗯，
这个或者是比较严重的欺诈呀，啊，这一类的问题，毒品啊这些，
嗯，
那个就算你有绿卡，那么一旦判完了刑，你完成了你的刑期，移民局就会找上门来，
嗯，
开始递解你出境。
完，犯罪就犯这个罪啊，跟你的身份没关系啊，对不对？跟他的身份没有关系啊，他是绿卡，他还是犯了这个法；他没有绿卡，他还是犯了这个法；他就是有公民，还是犯了这个法。那只按犯了这个法来判刑嘛，跟他持不了绿卡没关系。任何刑事犯 ，OK， 都移民局都有这个权把这个人的绿卡取消，但是公民就不一定了。
那
你问是为什么这法律啊？
还可以再办一次绿卡吗？
啊，如果他有这样，如果罪名成的话，应该不可以了。
终身的。
对。
为什么？
刑事犯嘛，移民法有规定啊，你刑事犯的人哈，一般都对可以驱逐你出境啊，OK，可以不让你重新申请绿卡。但是对他这个案的处理没有区别，他是绿卡还是中国公民还是美国公民，对他这个案子的处理没有区别。但是判了以后那就不同了，如果他是有罪的话，那移民局可能驱逐他出境啊，可能将来都不给他绿卡。
不管他是外国人有没有绿卡，
嗯，
还是美国公民，实际上在这个问题上，在这个刑事犯罪这个问题上是一样对待的，对吧？他到底有没有犯罪，
什么意思一样对待？
就是没有一个特殊的，说外国人更严一些，
哦，
美国人更松一些的，没有的，对吧？都是一样的。
天下人犯法。
对，你在美国犯法，不管是谁都是一样的，
嗯，
跟在中国也是一样，对吧？你外国人到中国犯法也是一样的。
Why all around the world the people, especially Chinese people, a lot of people, they want to immigrate to USA. Just like he talking about.What benefit we can get when we get a green card? But why the people want to immigrate to USA first? I don't know why.
First of all, a green card lets you live here permanently, gives you the opportunity, if you wish, to become a citizen. Now, beyond that, it's probably easier to become wealthy.In a wealthy country as opposed to a poor country. This is well known throughout the world as a land of opportunity. And,
the question is, I'm sorry, China is a wealthy country too.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Very wealthy country.
China is a wealthy country. Why?
There's no question about it. We have a long tradition of democracy, fair legal system.
Mm-hmm.
Of justice. These are things that, as a nation, we hold very, very dear to us. Fair play throughout the world. Also, this is a country that did the first heart transplant, put the first man on the moon, developed the first computers. technologically, we're the leading edge in many industries. China is certainly giving us a run for our money, and that competition is good. We recognize that.
Yeah.
China is also a very good trade partner. So there are, it's well established that the American dream is still alive. And someone who wants to aspire to the best they can, or for their children to get the best education, if you will, a world-class education, it's easier probably to do it in this country, to get that education in this country, than many other countries.
I agree with that. Yeah, education, the first computer. I love that.
First, definitely. There are very many things.
My idol.
Yeah.
I love him very, very much.
And the blue skies, you know.
Blue skies. Los Angeles is not a very blue sky.
Not bad. You
know. Not bad, yes.
Some days are better than others. Yeah. But actually, it's improved quite a lot in the last 20 years. Mm-hmm. The level of pollution in Los Angeles has really declined, mm-hmm. and because it's our government that has pushed for cleaner air and cleaner water, mm-hmm. so mm-hmm. We have better controls over the quality of our medicines, mm-hmm. Our food, our construction,
medical system. Mm-hmm.
So these things all
and
make
laws.
In the laws, right. That nobody
justice, freedom.
Nobody is above the law.
Yes.
Yeah. So we enjoy our freedoms, mm-hmm. and we would like everybody in the world to enjoy the same degree of freedom we do.
Yeah, we open. Yeah.
So these are some of the things that mm-hmm. make America mm-hmm. so attractive.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I agree with it totally.
Just to add on. Tom gave a very patriotic view of America, which is I agree with completely. But
no money.
Well,
sorry, America.
Actually, speaking of money, I was going to say another reason why Chinese people might want to look more towards America, because simply it is just cheaper to immigrate to the U.S. You know, EB-5. For instance, the investor immigration system in the United Kingdom it costs you $2 million. Australia, closer to 10 million. So, yes, America's great, but you know, other countries are great too. But if you have multiple countries to choose from, why not choose the cheaper one? Especially it comes with all the great benefits that Tom just listed right here.
Mm. Yeah. And in China, we have a great wall.
We're building one too now.
I think education system is. Probably number one reason for a lot of Chinese mm-hmm. parents mm-hmm. want their kids to come and study here. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of, first there are so many universities, right? So you can comparatively easily to get into a good school. And also now young people, even in elementary school, the parents will send them here mm-hmm. to study. So I think that's...
especially in Arcadia.
Yeah.
Yes.
So that's the reason, and we also talked about pollution, right? It's nowadays, a lot of my clients will say they prefer their kids live here in this country mm-hmm. and grow up, not in Beijing or Shanghai, you know. So it's it has become a big issue and a big factor for those people to come and live in this country.
Yeah, a lot of good things. So 这就是为什么我们现在听懂了，我们大家我们的观众朋友也听懂了，我们现在就是说绿卡的好处有这么多，这就是为什么他们不减退的一直是在热潮之中的那种往美国来移民，想获得绿卡实现美国梦。好，我们今天就到这里，我们下一次移民美国的节目再见，拜拜。
再见，
拜拜。Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.